What's up, fellas? So I had a loyal patron supporter that wanted me to explain how to stay in abundance during the pandemic. Okay, because obviously it's easier to be in abundance mindset when you can go out and do stuff. But he wants to know how not to fall into scarcity now that we all locked in the house. Well, see, guys, this is the problem with trying to get abundance from just having multiple women. See, that's the thing. So especially if you're a purple pill guy, how you gonna stay in abundance when you get in a relationship if you're a purple pill guy over here? And like I said, I don't judge nobody. Only ones I judge, and you know what, I don't even want to say I judge the blue pill simps, because they just naive and they haven't stumbled across my content or another red pill content creator's content, right? So they just haven't been privileged. All you motherfuckers that are over here, you experienced something and you was going through some bullshit and you went seeking answers, and that's how you fought. It's not like you was on YouTube looking at Graham Stephan financial videos and then they put me on a suggested over, are you watching Dave Ramsey videos and then here I am on the side over here. No, you was looking at some dating advice or something, some bullshit women was doing, and or you Googled some shit and you ran across my ass. Okay, so they just haven't been through that yet. But if they do, if they come across it, then they'll be just like you. They'll be over here learning just like you. But so that's the situation. So I don't even judge blue pill guys. They just naive. They just haven't seek knowledge yet. And the purple pill guys, I understand the guys who don't want to be out here digging them down and toss them to the side of the road. It's not what I want to do, but I don't judge guys like that, because I know that a lot of guys want to have a start a family and stuff like this. You just aware of the risk. You just know what the fuck to expect for it, and you not surprised by no bullshit women do. Okay? But if you trying to build your abundance mindset, or you need abundance of women to maintain your abundance mindset, you are fucked if that's the only way you can get it. Because no matter how great you are, no matter how good your dick is, at some point you might experience some type of drop. At some point. I ain't saying it's going to be 3 years, but maybe you for 3 months you might don't have no ass. Okay, I tell you guys to keep women in the friend zone or whatever, you might not even have that. So now how you going, when you meet a new chick, how you going to act in abundance? Abundance, guys, is all in your mindset. You have to have a lifestyle of abundance, not with the women. First of all, you have to master the ability to be alone. What do I mean by that? This is why I don't have friends, guys, or male friends, all right? It's because I enjoy my own company more than I do with other people, particularly males, not females. I love female companionship. But usually when I'm with dudes, they either talk too much, some bullshit, right? It's some bullshit. It's just like I just go out and I just enjoy my own space. Like I can deal with guys in short doses. Like I can go out with them, have a drink with them, but then I don't want to see them for 3 months. You see what I'm saying? That's how I am. I'm not saying you guys be like that. I want you guys to be a large social circles and stuff like that, because like they say, your net worth is determined by your network, how you network. All right, so just understand that, guys. So I don't want you guys, that's just what I do and that works for me. All right, like I told you guys, I'm a Sigma male and that works for me, and I'm proud of it. That's just who the fuck I am. I always been that fucking way, right? But that is where you get the base of your abundance from, when you can just enjoy your own company. If you constantly need people, friends or women, and you do not know how to enjoy your own company, what happens is when you get with a girl and she's acting bitchy, and when you get to thinking like, well, man, you know, I don't really got no friends and I don't really got no other ass right now, so I'm just going to take it because, you know, I can't be alone. You already have failed. When you can be alone, whether you have no friends or no other bitches, when you say to yourself, when this is what I mean by being alone, I'd rather be alone than tolerate this shit off of this bitch right here. That's what the ability to be alone does for you. when a woman is, let's just say you got one chick in your rotation, you have no other chicks, and you, let's just say you're a Sigma male like me, or let's say even if you do got a friend, you got a couple other friends, right? But let's just say they're in relationships, so they can't get out with you like that. They live with their girlfriends or whatever, so they can't get out like that, right? And you're going to have that once you get my age, by the way. When you get 40 years old, you ain't going to have a whole bunch of guys that can go out and party with you every weekend. I can tell you that shit now. Guys going to start having families. Guys going to have girlfriends, wives, fiancés. They ain't going to be able to get out and party with you like that. So let's say that you with this girl. She's getting on your fucking nerves, but you don't got no friends. You don't got no other bitch. Just got her. She's being difficult. And the thought of you being alone frighten you, because you like, well, I ain't got nobody else to hang out with. If I lose her, you already lost. See, when you got the ability to be alone, you say, I enjoy my own company more than I'm enjoying this bitch company, so she can go. So that's first and foremost. The second thing, guys, is you have to build a life of abundance. What do I mean that? You have 24 hours in a day. So let's just hypothetically say, right? Let's say, I know you guys might not sleep 8 hours a night, but let's just say between winding down and getting out of bed and brushing your teeth, let's just say that's 8 hours, right? So that means we got 16 hours to fill. Monday through Friday, right? Let's just say we purpose, guys, we're on our purpose. So Monday through Friday, I got 16 hours to fill. So let's say, let's break down the day, and let me explain, and y'all gonna see why when I say, like why I like to be alone. I'm finna break a typical day down. So I wake up. Well, let me break a typical day down for the average guy. The average guy don't do YouTube. So let me break down the average day of when I was working, had a regular job like the average one of you guys. The average guy don't have a YouTube type lifestyle. So you wake up, you go to school, you go to work, you get off at 4. So that means that's 8 hours gone right there. I that's 16 hours. You get home. Let's hypothetically say the gym is an hour, okay? Gym is an hour. That's working out cardio, right? Let's say you come back home, you're preparing your meals. Let's say you're preparing your meals, okay? Let's say that's taking another hour. So let's say you meal prep. And this goes to the basis of my high-value concepts, what I be talking about, guys. See, when you spend all that time working, gym, meal prep, purpose, when you spend that much time, that's 12 hours right there, right, that I just gave you. When you spend that much time being a high-value male as you possibly can, what you're doing is you've made yourself more susceptible to more women, but also more unavailable. This is what I try to tell you guys. This is not a front. When you guys live this lifestyle, that's 12 hours out your day that's gone. Work, gym, meal prep. 2 hours on purpose. Now, maybe you got 3-4 hours before bed that you need to kill. Any hobbies, anything like that. If not, maybe you setting up a date or something like that. That's all people get of your time. Let's hypothetically say you have none of that. Let's hypothetically say you have no friends. Let's hypothetically say you have no hobbies. Then maybe you work a little longer on your purpose. So instead of 2 hours on your purpose, maybe you're working 4. You see what I'm saying? What I'm saying is you built your life in as if you need nobody. Or let's say you just say, hey, I got a basketball game. You know, I know we ain't got that going on right now, but pre this, you know, you got your little basketball game. By the time the basketball game go off, it's time to get your ass in the shower and go to bed. And that's how you be in abundance. As if, build your day as if I have no woman ever, right? Build your day like that to where I don't need nobody. I go to school or I go to work. I come home. I go to the gym. I come home. I meal prep. I work on my purpose 2 or 3 hours. Maybe it's a basketball game on. Maybe it's a show that I recorded on DVR I'm finna watch or whatever. Or if I do got a couple other chicks. But my life is full. You should have a full life. You know what's wrong with the average person? They got school or they have a job. Then when they get home, they have nothing. And therein lies the problem. That's why you can't stay in abundance. You don't have a complete schedule. And this is why you lose. You get off at 4 and you done for the day. And now you're in scarcity because you're not working to be a high-value male. If you would have came home, went to the gym, came home, meal prepped, okay, didn't got on your purpose for 2 or 3 hours, writing a book or whatever, working on a program, you wouldn't fall into scarcity. But since you're not working to better yourself, you just work or go to school, once you get off of that, you got all this free time in your hand, now you fall into scarcity because you have nothing. This little void of not trying to better yourself, as in gym, meal prep, and I count meal prep, guys. The reason I count meal prep, if you're a guy over there and you're struggling with your weight, the reason you're struggling ain't because you're going to the gym. You don't put no time into meal prep. That's more important than the gym as far as your aesthetics. That's more, the gym is like 90% of what you're going to look like. I mean, the meal prep is like 90% of what you look like. The gym is only like 10%. You have to, if you're going to focus on the gym, you need to get that same amount of time on weighing your food and cooking your foods. And I'm just going to put this out there, guys. That goes a lot with your sex appeal. Not the way y'all guys think. Not the looks aspect of your sex appeal. The fact that you feel good about yourself, that's what's going to give you more charisma. I'm going to tell y'all guys something. That feeling good about the way you look, as far as your aesthetics, your body, that's going to give you more charisma than the money. When a man feels sexy, he acts sexy. And that's the epitome of sex appeal. When you feel sexy, you act sexy. When you don't feel sexy, you don't act sexy. Money don't give you that. $1 million don't give you, won't make you feel sexy. But when you feel good about your weight and how you look in the mirror, that'll make you act sexy. So for all you guys that talk about sex appeal, it basically comes down to how you feel about yourself. And I'm going to tell you right now, one of the biggest things to work on is your weight. There ain't nothing you could do about your facial structure. I can't change the way my face look. Well, maybe I could with cosmetic surgery, but y'all guys get what I mean. But I can control my body weight, which does contribute greatly to my facial structure. As y'all guys know, the jawline and all that other shit, cheekbones, all that other shit. I'm going to tell you that, guy. So I want you guys to be doing the self-improvement constantly. That should be what fills your fucking day. And then you throw a chick in. If you meet a chick and she's acting right, okay, bitch, you can come over at 8 o'clock. I go to bed at 10. You got 2 hours. But if you don't got a chick, okay, I'll just watch a basketball game in that time. That should be how you stay in abundance, guys. Job or school, gym, meal prep, purpose, hobbies. Those hobbies could be watching basketball, flying a kite, playing video games, whatever. When you build your life that way, when you have all those things in your life, a woman is just something that just fills in the voids when you can find time. It's not something you need. So that's how you stay in abundance. I'm in abundance. I haven't, except on the weekend. I mean, I'm in abundance all the time. But the only time I really feel like I need more to do is on the weekend. Because as y'all guys know, I always took the weekend off. All right. But Monday through Friday, I'm on these videos. I'm answering emails. I'm working on my next book. My day is full. For the last year or so, I didn't do as much on the weekend because I felt like I deserved the weekend off. So on the weekends, I can feel like, man, I wish I had something to do. But I do got a couple of chicks I see, so it's not that big a fucking deal. It's really more of, I wish it was somewhere I could go, if that makes sense, other than being locked in the fucking house, right? So that's the thing with that guy. That's how you stay in fucking abundance, man. You have to build your life complete from the time you wake up to the time you go to bed. And if you meet a chick, okay, you can fill the ass in that little 2 or 3 hours before you go to bed. All right, I'll get back with you guys later, man.